Starting with OBS Studio version 20, OBS Studio has included an auto configuration wizard, which will allow you to get a stream up and running with optimized stream settings without having to thoroughly learn the software. So if you've been looking for the easy way to get it done video from this course, this is it. Let's jump in and go through how to use it. The auto configuration wizard is found in the tool drop-down menu. You have three options to start off with: either optimizing for streaming, optimizing for recording, or set up for the use of the OBS virtual cam only. The first option is for if you plan on streaming to Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, or whatever the platform of your choice, but also possibly plan to record on a local drive for editing later. Select this option and click Next. In Video Settings, you'll choose your base or canvas resolution and frame rate. Note that this does not necessarily mean the resolution of your stream or record file. Those may be scaled down by choice. For FPS, you have a few options. You can choose a static selection of 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second, a variable frame rate with a preference to 60, or a variable frame rate with a preference to whichever will give you a higher resolution. You can also select Use Current. On a new profile, this is set to 30 frames per second by default. Most streaming situations will call for the variable frame rate with a preference for the 60 frames per second option. So you may have to choose: do you want the smoothest possible video or a more detailed, higher resolution video? Next, you'll input your stream information for the platform of your choice. The most popular destinations are listed, or you can click Show All to choose from just about any platform that supports live streaming, or you can even put in your own server information. For this example, we'll be streaming to Twitch. You can connect OBS to your Twitch account by either logging in to your account or by using your stream key. If you want to use your stream key, this is found under the Streaming tab in your Creator dashboard. For YouTube, the key is located in your live stream control room for either a scheduled live event or once you set up a stream. Never show your key to anyone or share it. If you do, they will be able to stream to your channel. If you ever accidentally show it, reset it immediately. Once you have your key, copy and paste it into the box, then choose your server. I recommend leaving this on auto. You can then set your bitrate. This is the target speed of sending the stream data from your computer to your streaming platform. This will be limited by your internet connection. Typically, you want your total bitrate to be half of the upload speed of your internet connection. You also have a checkbox for prefer hardware encoding. In a nutshell, hardware encoding uses your graphics card's extra processing power to encode the video and relieve the load on your CPU processor. This can perform a lot better, but it doesn't look as good, at least for live streams. For recordings, it won't have an impact. You'll need a dedicated NVIDIA or AMD graphics card to use hardware encoding. You can check the box if you want if it's not available on your system, but it just won't use it. Click Next. If you left the Estimate Bitrate with Bandwidth Test box checked on the last screen, the tool will now ping local servers to choose the best for your streaming platform. Give it a few minutes. This will also test your system's performance to determine the best resolution, bitrate, and other settings. Once the test is complete, you can review these changes. When it's done, click Apply Settings. And that's it for streaming. Make sure you run a few test streams to make sure everything is working. If you do want to record your stream VODs, I would recommend you make a couple of tweaks to the auto-configured settings. Click settings and go to output, then under the recording tab, I would change the recording format to MKV. You can use MP4. It is the most widely compatible format, but it is prone to corruption. If you use MKV, the files will stay intact and still be usable even if your session crashes, and you can still use multiple audio tracks. The default selected, FLV, cannot record multiple audio tracks. Once you finish recording, you can go to File, then Remix Recording, and convert that file back to an MP4 for editing if needed. Or, in the Recording section of the Advanced tab in the Settings menu, you can set recordings to automatically remix when recording ends. I also recommend changing the recording path to the location of your choice. Next, let's run through the configuration wizard for recording. Note, you can only run the configuration wizard once. If you do it a second time, it will replace your previous settings. So if you want different settings for recording one day and streaming another, you have to use multiple profiles. You can do this by going to Profile, clicking New, giving your new profile a name. The next lesson will be all about profiles and their uses. Now, we'll set up OBS for higher quality recordings. Again, go to Tools and click on Auto Configuration Wizard. This time, click Optimize for Just Recording, I Will Not Be Streaming, and click Next. For video settings, you have the same options as before. Again, note this does not necessarily mean the resolution you are recording to. You also have the same options for frame rate. For most streaming situations, you would want to probably choose the variable frame rate with the preference for 60 frames per second option. But for recording, you might choose the variable frame rate with the preference to higher resolution instead. This will prioritize the resolution of your video, 4K, for example, over achieving 60 frames per second. In the end, it's up to you. Click Next, and the tool will run a system test to determine the best recording settings for you. Review them and click Apply Settings to begin using them. Once again, I do recommend you make a couple of tweaks to the auto-configured settings. Click Settings and go to Output. Then under the Recording tab, I would change the recording format to MKV. You can use MP4. It is the most widely compatible format, but it's prone to corruption. If you use MKV, the files will stay intact and still be usable, even if your session crashes. And you can still use multiple audio tracks. The default selected, FLV, cannot record multiple audio tracks. Once you've finished recording, you can go to File, then Remix Recording, and convert that file back to an MP4 for editing if needed. Or, in the Recording section of the Advanced tab in the Settings menu, you can set recordings to automatically remix once recording ends. I also recommend you change the recording path to the location of your choice. Now, let's talk about the last option in the Auto Configuration Wizard. This option is used to set up the OBS Virtual Cam, which allows you to send your OBS output as a video source that you can then use as a camera in other programs like Skype, Zoom, and so on. So anything that you have showing up in OBS will appear on your camera feed. Again, go to Tools and click on Auto Configuration Wizard. This time, click I Will Only Be Using the Virtual Camera and click Next. And that's it. Since the virtual cam just sends the data from OBS to other programs, the tools will then run a system test to determine the best settings for you. Review them and click Apply Settings to begin using them. And that's it for the Auto Configuration Wizard. It might seem strange that in a course designed to show you the ins and outs of the software, I would show you a way to get set up without needing the rest of the course. But the purpose of this course is to help you learn everything about OBS, even the things that might make the rest of this course unnecessary for you. Hopefully, this helps you through the process of getting set up initially in OBS. That's it for this lesson. If this lesson was helpful for you, please do me a favor and hit the like button and tell a friend about this course. I'll see you next time, and as always, stream on.